Today we are going to look at Jeffree Star's Skin Frosts. You already know this from the title. But you know, yeah, I have all his Skin Frosts and I also have the two palettes. So I thought I was going to swatch them and talk a bit about them and so on. This is not a review, it's just showing them like I did with the liquid lipsticks from the holiday collections and so on. So I will not have the liquid frosts or the supreme frosts in here, only the other ones. And I just want to start off by saying that when I show you my palettes, I'm going to show you why I don't, if I can avoid it, I will not shop from Jeffree Star's cosmetics own website, because the customer service is like so bad. Maybe I could show you right now so I have it out of the way so I don't have to think about it. But okay, I usually, before this happened, I always order from the Jeffree Star website, even though it takes forever to get here. No other brands that I buy from in the States or something like that takes that long. And even though I have to pay a custom fee that is so big, I still do it because I like how they wrap everything and they have the individual papers and so on, and you know that it's from his brand and so on and so on. But now, and usually before, the releases got to his site before they got to the retailers and so on. But nowadays I shop it from Beautylish or Beauty Bay, because if I buy from Beauty Bay I don't have to pay customs at all. And if I buy it from Beautylish, I have to pay customs, but they kind of calculate it before, and it's always much cheaper than the postal service in Sweden take out, when they take out the fee. But anyway, when these two palettes released, the Platinum Eyes and the 24 Karat, it's not called gold, no, I ordered it from there. It took like, I don't know, but it took so long, like 2 months or something like that, to get to me. And when I got them, and it's like this, if I pay, they cost $40 each. And yeah, it's not that expensive, but it's absolutely not affordable. But then I expect some quality. And first of all, when I open the Platinum Eyes, this one is not that bad as the other one. I'm sorry, I'm going to show you the mirror, but this mirror is crooked. Hello! I know it doesn't show up that well here, but you know, the frame is cut, it's crooked anyway. But it's not that much that I can't live with it, but anyway. And the ice cold is starting to come out of the packaging, because the packaging is really cheap. Yeah, so that was my issue with this one. With the 24 karat, there is nothing wrong with the pans, but I don't know if you can see the mirror in this. It's so crooked. It looks like I've got, what's it called? A fake one. Like I've ordered it from AliExpress or something. And I have ordered this from Jeffree's own site. And then I wrote to the support, the customer service. I have done that before and they are not very quick. And they have a thing that if you send them more than one email before they have replied to you, then they will block you and all of your emails will come to their trash bin. Excellent feature. But anyway, somehow I got through after sending 3 emails because they wouldn't respond to me. And I explained as good as I could in English, which is not that easy, what was wrong with them. And I tried to take pictures that showed how crooked this was, and that was not easy as well. But I explained the problem. And they, after taking like a week to reply to me, they said like, oh, you have to take a picture, a better picture. Okay, then I took a better picture, which is again not easy to show off a crooked mirror. And then I sent that to them, and then they said, oh, we have to, you have to send it with the the invoice, which I don't understand because they know that I have bought it. So why would I need the invoice in the picture? And how am I going to take a picture that shows both the invoice and the mirror so you can see that it's crooked? Oh, it was so hard. And then I send that to them and they replied after 2 weeks saying, or 1 week maybe it was, there is nothing wrong with your product. And then they wouldn't reply to me for... I didn't get any reply, and I think it's so bad. I have bought so many things from their site, and not that that matters, because you should get great customer service even though you have just bought one thing. But to treat your customers like that... So I have this crooked shit. There's nothing wrong with the products, but it looks so cheap. So I'm so annoyed. So I haven't bought anything from his site since then. And I really hope that I don't have to. Or have to. I don't have to buy anything, but you know what I mean. Anyway, that felt good. Oh, ventilating. I haven't like told many people in my life because no one understands, but you know, you understand. So yeah, that took 6 minutes of my life. But anyway, I have all of the other skin frosts, and unfortunately I have duplicates of one, and that is also because of an incident with the customer service, but I won't explain that because but yeah, so I thought I was going to swatch them, and I have done this on mine. I put on a sticker here and here because they all look like the same, and I have them on display. You can see that in my makeup collection video if you want to see it more. But I thought we were going to start out with the permanent ones. Some of his limited edition you can still buy, but you know, they are limited edition, so I guess that when they run out of stock, they run out of stock. But yeah. He started up by releasing 4, and these ones are big. It's like the Marc Jacobs ones. They are bigger actually. Oh, that was great. But you know, they are really, really big. Do I have something that is not that big? I should have prepared for this, but I can take a ColourPop highlighter. You know, they are really big. There are 15 grams in it. And they released 4 shades. And one of the most popular ones are Ice Cold. And it's an icy white, very pale color. I actually thought that this was like pink, but it actually isn't. It's gold. So it's a very icy gold. And I must say that these get very easily hard pan. You can take it off, of course, by using tape or whatever, but you shouldn't have to. But
vad gör du? Gumman? Du kan sova lite till. Ja, du kan sova lite till.
Ja. Oh, lock it. But I will just do swatches with my finger, so you know. And we'll take these. They are not the same formula in each of them. Some are very powdery, some are very creamy, some are very crumbly, and yeah. But this one looks like that. Ooh, ice cold. See if I can swatch. Now I'm very pale, so it may not show. And these ones, when you swatch them with the finger, they look very crumbly, but of course you will buff them in. I can take a little bit more so you can see. These are actually highlighters, so you know. They won't show up that well, but you can see it like that. That was Ice Cold. And then they released, I think that 3 of the ones I'm going to show you are some of the most popular ones, because each of them fit, I think, a different kind of skin tone. But this is the Peach Goddess, and as it sounds, it's a peach, but it's more like a pink peach, I would say. This is really popular. I'm more like, you know, yeah, it's a highlighter but also a blush topper. I'm so bad at swatching. but you can see it's very peachy. It's so pretty. And then we have King Tut. That is too dark for me to use as a highlighter, I think. But, you know, you can use them for other things. I think almost every one of these are eye safe. There is one that isn't eye safe that I know of. But otherwise, they're all eye safe. This is King Tut. It's more like a brown. There's a lot of these shades. So maybe we should swatch these in two places. We can compare all the browns. That I will do. Great idea, Jessica. Thank you. It's a gold. Like that. And I'm going to swatch. I will get this everywhere, but I will swatch it over here as well. So we can compare all the gold ones or brown ones. So you can see it there. I'm going to be so shiny. And then of course he has to have a crazy color because, you know. And I think that is funny because, yeah, maybe you won't use it as a highlighter, but you know, it's fun. And this is mint condition. They all look like this, so I don't know why I'm showing you. But it's this one. I think it's really pretty. I have used this for eyeshadow. So pretty. I'm going to say so pretty a lot of times. Maybe you could count them. Like that. You will never run out of this. Oh, I will not fit all of them here, I just realized, because I'm swatching them so far apart. Well, that's a problem when that comes. Well, that was the four ones he released first. I don't know if this was in, I think it was in the beginning of 2016. Doesn't it say that on the back? No, of course not. But yeah, so these four. Then he released four more. And the one I love the most from that collection is the Lavender Snow. And it's the only time I love lavender. And it's a gray-purple kind of highlighter. Why do I say it's a highlighter? All of them are supposed to be. Now I'm trying to do it more closely. And it's really pretty. It looks a lot darker in the pan than it actually is. I have used this for highlighter. Can you see? Oh. Yeah, not the greatest swatch, but you know, you get the picture. It's really pretty. Like that. And then we have a new gold one, and it's so fucking gold. This is not as crumbly, it's more finely milled. You can see the hard pan here. See if we can. So it's more like an old gold. Take some more. You can see. Ooh, it tickles. And then we take on the other side. These two you can see a big difference between, but you know, when we get to the other colors it gets much harder. Then we have another brown, and it's a dark horse. They all look the same. It's more a bronzy brown. I kind of have them, if you are interested, in the order, of course, from when they were released, but then also in from light to dark, and the crazy colors in the end. So there will be a crazy color as well. This one is really, really pigment. I don't have to press hard at all. This is a beautiful eyeshadow for me, for of course I can't use that as a highlight without it showing up. Like that. And then the crazy color is Deep Freeze. It's a blue one that I have used on a blue lipstick. So pretty. What was the blue lipstick? I think it was Kat Von D's blue lipstick. I don't remember the name of it, but yeah. It's so cool. You can see it's a bit crumbly, but you know. Work it in. It's so cool. Yes. And then came Halloween. And he did a funny thing by releasing a black highlighter. And of course, maybe there are some people that use it as a highlighter. You shouldn't say that you can't use it. But obviously I can't use it. And it's a very big black eyeshadow. But it's a shimmery black. That's not that often they do shimmery black in palettes. Either they put in a matte black or they put in matte black with glitters. No. So it's actually good to have a matte black, a shimmery black. I think it's kind of funny, so. It's very shimmery. I think it's good for Halloween looks. And that they released on Halloween. I don't think it was for Black Friday, but it doesn't matter, but yeah. And now I'm doing the permanent ones in the order they came out, and then in the middle of some of them, they released some of their limited edition. He hasn't released some in a while, except for one I'm going to show you, but yeah. But then he released two pink ones, and one is Princess Cut, and it's a very pale pink. Really pretty. And this one gets hard pan as see if you can see it there. It's really hard to show you, but yeah, see if we can get some color of it anyway, because I don't want to take it on another side. And I know it gets hard pan because my oil's in the finger, but it gets hard pan when you use it with a brush as well, so. Let's see if I can get the hard pan off. Ooh. I'm actually going to try this trick because I've never tried it with the tape before. Oh, it worked. But you know, it's wasteful. Oh God, have I put down my hand there? I have highlighter everywhere. But the hard pan kind of disappeared as well. But now it's back. Yeah, but this is really, really pale and not easy to apply with. I can try with a brush actually. Let's see if it shows up. And it gets hard pan with the brush as well, so. Oh, it's so pretty. You can't see it probably, but no. But it's such a pretty shimmer. Oh, I love that one. It's one of the more, that looks more like a natural highlighter to me. Not a natural, it's still bling. But you know, not a crazy one. And then we have the Regina George. That one is not eye safe, but you know. And it's chunky as crazy, and it's really, really, really pink, but it's not that pink on the face, but you know, it's still pink, so. And that one get hard pan as well. I can hardly see the Princess Cut, but we try to do this. That will stain my arm. But you can see it's not that intense as it is in the pan. But you know, it's still a pink that I will use as a blush or something. But I actually would more likely use it as an eyeshadow that would stain the eye than have the stain on the face. So I don't know how they were thinking there, but you know. Then they released the next two are the last two permanent ones, and they are, in my book, kind of boring, but you know. Somebody asked for them, I guess. And it's the Siberian gold. A gold one, but it's a lighter gold. And hard pan. Can you see it there? So it's a really light gold. And we will put it over here. Oh God. God, I hate hard pan. Now I used my nail. Nails? Yeah, it's called nails. But you can see it's more like a lighter gold. I really dug my hand into that. Yes. And then we have one that is, you can find this in one of the palettes, and it came out afterwards, and it's sarcophagus, maybe? Sarcophagus? I'll show you. And what do you know? It's a light gold. And this looks just like, was it Dark Horse? It's really finely milled, or was it so fucking gold? And those don't get that much hard pan as the other ones do. Now I can't really see what I'm doing. Can you see what I'm doing? There. It's really powdery, but pretty. And that one is so much easier to use. You can see that one is lighter. Like that. And I'm thinking to take these off, but these are the ones, God, it's so, I don't know how to hold, but you can see them. Starting with ice cold down to sarcophagus over here. And I'm going to take these off. These are the ones in his permanent collection, and that one is Princess Cut, so you can just see the shimmer. And then we have five that are limited edition. And we can start off with, he did a collab with Manny MUA. At the first, he released the Eclipse one, and it's in the black packaging. It's really pretty. And this one is matte. The other one is, you know, shiny. And it's holographic. Yay! And this one is called Eclipse. And the first time they released it, it looks like this, you know, with the star and the moon, but you know, it looks like Black Moon Cosmetics, but you know. And yeah, we'll take this. It's really pale brown gold champagne. I think that is champagne. Can you see it? It's over there. Why didn't I swatch over here? But it's over there. And I thought I was going to take it over here. Oh my God, the hard pan. That's why I don't use this as much as I want to, because it drives me insane. But you can see this one is such more lighter than the other ones. You can barely see it, but I like it. I'm going to try the tape. You can see the hard pan over there, and woohoo! I'm so impressed by this technique, you know, but as I said, it's kind of wasteful. Then they released another collab, it's the same collab, but you know, and Uranus. And they also released Eclipse again, but, oh, wait, where did that come from? Wait, I have highlighter everywhere. Did I get that from the tape? Like that. And like I said, for some reason I have them both, but I haven't touched the other Eclipse, but you know, it's hard to sell as well, even though it's not used. Ooh. So they look like this, you know. So that is Eclipse, and it looks the same as the other one, so I'm not going to swatch it. Oh, it looks like I've touched it there, but I haven't, so. And this is Uranus. I don't like the name, but it's a gold. Can you see it? And of course, the gold swatches over here as well. Oh, that. So there's a gold for you if you want to. These are not the last gold, I think. Can you see? There is Uranus and that's Eclipse. There are more lighter ones for me. God, I'm shimmery. Oh, I thought this was going to be a quick video, but now I don't know. Like that, speed it up. And then he released for the summer collection, the Chrome collection, these ones that the fingerprints show up. But it's, you know, chromey. And we have Crystal Ball, and that actually is a white with... No, that's not pink at all. Never mind. But it looks like white, and this is this chunky one that Ice Cold is as well. You can see. Yeah, I think there is pink. Yeah, there is pink. It doesn't look like it in the pan, but you know. No, I was just going to swatch it over here, but that I don't need to. But that, and then we have Summer Snow Cone, and it's like a yellow, a dark yellow. I think it's kind of funny. Shade. It looks more dark in the pan, but you know. Can you see how pale these four are? I'm not going to put it over here. And then the last one he released with the family collection, and it's the Jeffree one, and it's baby pink with holographic. It's not an exciting... Oh, I forgot this one was pink. It's a little more pink than the Princess Cut. Maybe we can swatch Princess Cut below. But you can see this a bit more. This one shows up a little bit more than the Princess Cut. And I'm not going to swatch that. But you could barely see it. This one you can actually see that there is a pink one. Undertone. Yeah. So that was all his single Skin Frosts. And I will wipe away these pretty colors. You know, I can only say it from my perspective. From a pale woman. So I don't know how this will look on other skin tones. I actually don't know. Then we have the palettes. Oh, shimmer, 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 shimmer. Like that. And we first have this, the Platinum Eyes. And I must say that the card box, no. The box that it came in is more prettier than the actual print, but you know. And in this we have 6 colors, and 2 of them are existing colors, and it's Ice Cold and it's Lavender Snow. So I won't swatch them, but I will swatch the other 4. And he also have a new formula, and it's this Pink Chill, and it's not as full on highlighter as the other one. It's more like a topper, and it's more like a duochrome, I would say. But we will take Glacier, and it's a silvery one. Oh, then he has a silvery. No, it was a silvery liquid lipstick that I wanted. That's right. Nothing. It was nothing. I haven't used these ones in the palette as much as the other ones. Can you see it? There. And these, I think this is geared more towards... paler or lighter skin tones. And then we have Alien Eyes, and it's a green one. Gold green, I would say. you see it there? It's a green one. And now we have the pink shill.
Oh,
is that the panda or loose?
Yeah.
Also, the quality of these palettes. I think that is actually kind of pretty. It is a duochrome. It's gold and pink. Can you see it? Can I see it? I see it over here. I don't think you can see it. It's not that full on, but you can see a bit of shimmer over here. It's not supposed to be, for those who don't like it. But I can definitely see it, and you will definitely see it if you use it. But, you know, swatching on a white arm doesn't always go so well. And then we have Canary Bling, and it's more like a yellow. Can you see it there? I think they're all very pretty, actually. And if I were just going, if I was a normal person, I would only have bought this, because you know it's for me. But yeah, who likes to be normal? The other one I'm going to show you are more for medium to deep skin tones, I think he said. But you know, they have is it spelled like that? Now I'm a chick. Sarcophagus. When they released this one, Sarcophagus wasn't a single. So when they released it, there were only two shades that have been released before. And it's Dark Horse and King Tut. And these four were new shades. But now we also have this one. So these ones are the ones I'm going to swatch. And we start with the red one called Legendary. That is really pretty.
Yay.
Then we have Giza. Did I say that this palette was called 24 karat? I don't know. That one you can see better. Then that one we are going to swatch over here. Oh, I put... Oh God, how terrible. But you get the picture. There are a lot of browns and bronzes and, you know. Yeah, can I take this off? Like that. And we only have the Liberace color. Liberace. I'm going to say Liberace. And it's the gold one. Really, really yellow gold. I like yellow gold. I think those colors are really nice, especially Liberace and Legendary. They are so unique, that one especially. But yeah, that was all of Jeffree Star Skin Frost, and now I'm going to put everything back. Yay. But so you can see them a bit. It's not a very, it's not a review, it's not nothing like that. It's just so you can see them, and you know, if you're thinking of buying some for the Black Friday, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, I enjoyed doing this video at least, so that was all I was going to say. So, bye!